Hey, Art family, if you like this one, the full-length version's on Patreon.
They are skillful.
Hello, Art family, and thank you to all the new subscribers. For this video, I wanted to take a look at some strategies for chasing after the light of a subject when the light and the weather is constantly changing on you while you're trying to paint on location. This sketch was done at the Mertz Library in the New York Botanical Gardens. I sort of showed clips of this in a recent vlog video that I posted showing kind of the day there at this plein air painting event. And this one was kind of, it was like everything that you worry about happening when you're plein air painting, happening all at once when I was painting this scene. I mean, not to mention just the people stopping by and talking to me, which is not really a big deal. But in the hour it took to paint this painting, I had the light completely change on me. About every 10 to 20 minutes, it would be completely different. When I started doing the sketch, it was lightly raining and it was very cloudy, so I knew it was going to be very wet and damp and hard for the watercolor to dry, which it was in the very beginning. But as you see in the background of this, the light was constantly changing and the sun was coming and going out of clouds. There was a dense fog. It was rainy at one point. It was sunny at another point. And I went into this chasing the reference photo, which was very foggy and kind of dense clouds all through the sky. And so initially that was what I chased after. And I think my advice for chasing the light and trying to pursue a particular strategy is, well, a couple things. One is always go with a strategy. Figure out a strategy right from the get-go. You can do that by getting a sketchbook and doing a small kind of credit card or business card sized sketch of just the simple arrangement of value shapes. That's going to ultimately be the kind of goal and the key that holds the thing together. So initially it didn't look like the weather was going to change at all, and so I approached this doing a small thumbnail sketch where the light was all in the sky and everything else was a slightly darker value and then subdivided within that, which you can see in the reference photo. But now you can see things changed a lot. The clouds dispersed slightly, so there's bits of blue which changed the arrangement of value pieces that clicked together. But the one thing that stays consistent is this simple structure of shapes. And so now that has changed. And that's what I'm chasing after now. This is an 18 by 24 arches watercolor block. And so I'm using a 2.5 inch flat brush because I can attack these shapes very quickly and efficiently. And I know that I don't have a lot of time with this light because all around me are pretty intense storm clouds. So in this little moment, I had about a 10-minute, 15-minute window to lock down this 18 by 24 rather large scene in terms of the lighting structure. So what I go for is I go for that simple arrangement of shapes. And essentially what I'm looking at, if you can see in the background, most of the face of this building is all in shadow. And I know by the science of light that it's going to mostly be cool. And I'm always going to vary from ultramarine or cobalt into burnt sienna or burnt umber. So I know that. So what I want to chase after now, instead of going after my thumbnail sketch that I have on the side, I'm going to now attack a very simple shape. So now, the blue of the sky might be slightly, very slightly hairline darker than the light of the building. So I set some very bright kind of orange and yellow ochre on the lighter parts, but essentially, I have two kind of pizza slices or two kind of pie wedges of light, and then the rest of it is in shadow, and that's all I need to know. That's what I have to get right. So I got that large shape clicked in, and initially, before I did any painting, I did a kind of arbitrary two-point perspective grid. First, I established my eye line, which is crucial to me because I want to put some small figures in this to help give scale to the overall scene. And then from there, I did a kind of arbitrary fan out of perspective lines. And I'm not really one to get into the specifics of the details of the correct number of windows or columns or things like that. I want to go for the overall atmosphere and the feeling, the sense of being on location in this spot. And that's the other thing I would advise you to do. And a crucial thing when you're doing your sketch is to just bear in mind what the sketch is about. So ask yourself before you get into it, what is the thing that is important to you? What stands out to you? And what are you after here that drew you into wanting to paint this thing in the first place? And to me, I really liked the kind of epic scale of this building. I liked the way that light interplayed with all the kind of intricate details of things, but the actual specific intricate details are not that interesting to me. And so I want to go for this overall atmospheric approach, and initially I'm going to knock in those big shapes of value. That's kind of my key to this map. I place my map down, and from there I can begin to subdivide, and you could subdivide as much as you want. Just continue subdividing into more and more accurate details. For me, I'm going to start subdividing into these smaller shapes and then placing some windows here and there. But I want to get into the figures and placing in the foliage because to me, I want to express this overall atmospheric scene and place these value shapes, kind of puzzle pieces, in the scene, and then hopefully in context, they will all kind of click together for the viewer. It's almost like a magic trick in a sense. I want to provide the viewer with A and C and allow their brain to complete the B of all the intricate details without having to noodle away at all the individual little columns and things like that. Plein air painting can be liberating. It can also be extremely stressful and frustrating because regardless of the weather, every 20 minutes, the light is going to completely change all your shadows and things like that. So the best you can do is try to keep things simple. Get a lot of experience and practice so that you can roll with it. Most of the actual painting happens in the moment. It's more a correcting of the mistakes than putting down the perfect sketch right from the beginning. Well, that's going to be it for this demo. I hope you got a lot out of it. I appreciate you watching, and I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching.